Hello and welcome to MIDAS Tutorials. In this tutorial, I'm going to give you a brief overview of the statistics and reporting capabilities within MIDAS. And these are accessed via this toolbar icon. On this screen, there's a drop-down list in the upper left corner, so we can view reports and statistics for various different things, including bookings, clients, invoices, resources, venues, users, and MIDAS itself. So we're currently on bookings. And you'll see in the upper right corner, we have a date range selector, so we can view statistics for bookings over specific ranges. Here I've got the whole of the month of June selected. And you'll see there's a graph here showing the number of bookings taking place on each day during that date range. And there are a number of other graphs we can display as well. For example, we can see when bookings have been added. Then you can see 9 bookings were added on this date here. Or we can view the booking type breakdown. So we can see 2/3 of the bookings between this date range are confirmed types. In the lower right corner, there's additional statistics about our bookings. So the average number of bookings on days with bookings, the average booking length, the total number of attendees, the average attendees per booking, and the number of bookings with resources. And we can further filter all these booking statistics by a specific booking type as well if we wish. So those are the booking statistics. If we go for the next one, which is clients, this will give us information on all the clients within MIDAS, the number of clients that have been added, modified and deleted in the past 30 days, total number of clients in MIDAS, total number of organisations in MIDAS, who the newest client to be added is, the number of emails that have been sent to clients in MIDAS in the past 30 days, and then the most popular clients with bookings and organisations with bookings. And again, we can further filter these by specific clients. So if I select John Smith, we can then see when he was added to the system, the number of bookings that are in the system for him, when his first booking was, when his most recent booking was, when his next booking is, when the very last booking in the system is for him, the total booking time, so that's a combination of all the bookings for John Smith in the system, and you see they add up to 2 days and 11 hours, the average booking length for John Smith's bookings, and the total number of invoices in the system for John. If we view invoices, MIDAS will present us with a range of statistics on our invoices over the date range we've selected. So we can see a breakdown of which clients have been invoiced, which clients have made payments, and which clients still have payments outstanding. MIDAS will also show us an uninvoiced bookings report at the bottom, showing the number of bookings for each client that have yet to be invoiced. Next up is our resources statistics. This will show us which resources are in use over the date range we've selected and the potential income we could make from those. And we can further filter these down by specific venue. Venues shows us a breakdown of our venue usage. So here you can see that room 2 is the most popular venue. We can also view venue utilization. So this shows us exactly how many hours each venue is booked for over the specific date range, out of the total number of hours available. And this takes into account our hours of operation for each venue. We can also view a current availability report. This will show us all our venues and whether they are available now, or if not, when they're next available. The potential income report will break down our bookings and show the potential income we could have from those bookings if they were all to be invoiced. And finally, the venue capacities shows us our maximum occupancy levels for each of our venues. And again, all the venue reports we can filter down to individual rooms as well if we wish. So there we go, we can see the usage for room 1 over the date range. Users will give us insight into our user activity, so we can see how active users have been. Again, this is useful to use in conjunction with the recent activity log, which will further go into details of specific actions that each user has taken. And finally, MIDAS will show us some statistics about our MIDAS system. It will show us the current version we're running, when that was built, how old that build is. There's also the change log. And also below that, there's some diagnostics on your browser and the server that you're running MIDAS from. It's also worth noting that any of these statistics pages can be printed. So let's go back to bookings, booking type, popularity. Yeah, that one will do. All we do to print this report is click the print icon. And MIDAS will pop open a print dialog for the currently selected report, allowing us to print it. Or if you're running Windows 10 or have a PDF printer installed, you can additionally save the report as a PDF file. And there we can see what the report would look like on our printout. One final thing to mention as well is that MIDAS allows you to export data. So if you wish to generate your own reports or analysis in a third-party tool, for example Excel, then data can be exported. And this is covered in one of our other video tutorials. So thanks for watching, and be sure to check out some of our other video tutorials online.